Now, one of the common misconceptions is that CBD can boost your immunity to the virus. The National Consumers League is warning people that that belief is false. In general, they say CBD products are unregulated, untested, and possibly mislabeled. Dr. Ned Legarry with MDVIP says while the evidence about boosting immunity falls short, there are some things you can do to make yourself less susceptible to disease. He says a good nutrition works, and staying physically active causes your antibodies and white blood cells to circulate faster. That means they could detect and fight bugs more quickly. Being active and well-rested also lowers stress hormones, which reduces your chance of getting sick. Studies have proven healthy adults who are sleep-deprived are more likely to get a cold.
Sleep doesn't just start from when you get into bed. It's more the wind down process and de-stressing process, right? To get good quality sleep, and so you're not kind of in bed, kind of tossing and turning, kind of being anxious.
Yeah, and other false claims about fighting coronavirus: hot baths, showers, or steam therapy. Steam therapy can only thin mucus and ease congestion that comes with cold or flu symptoms. The FDA warned several companies that make essential oils, teas, and other supplements to stop making virus-fighting claims. Cheryl?
All right, thank you for the update, Shannon. The FDA is approving a new test to determine if people have already developed antibodies to the coronavirus. Meanwhile, as Natalie Brand reports, the president is considering a very limited travel ban for areas that have been hard hit by this pandemic.
The FDA is announcing it has approved the first test that can detect whether people have already developed antibodies to COVID-19.
The peace of mind that would come from knowing you already were infected, you have antibody, you're safe from reinfection 99.9% of the time.
The coronavirus response coordinator, Dr. Deborah Burke, says the task force is working with universities across the country to develop these types of tests.
I think that would be very reassuring to the healthcare workers who have been on the front line. We worry about them every day.
To stop the spread of the virus, President Trump says he's considering a limited travel ban for areas hardest hit by the pandemic, but a decision has not been made.
I am looking where flights are going into hotspots, but closing up every single flight on every single airline, that's a very, very, very rough decision.
The president also confirmed the national stockpile of medical equipment for emergencies is almost completely drained.
The National Guard is moving a lot of this equipment and medical supplies into a hospital or into an area where it's needed by the state.
State leaders say they're still competing against each other for supplies, prompting New York Senator Chuck Schumer to call on the president to streamline the process under the Defense Production Act.
We need him to put in charge a czar of the whole production and distribution of these materials under the DPA.
President Trump, responding to Senator Schumer, tweeted, "Remember, we are a backup for them. The complainers should have been stocked up and ready long before this crisis hit. Other states are thrilled with the job we've done." Natalie Brand, CBS News, the White House.
Here at home, a popular local actor is doing his part to help end the global coronavirus pandemic. Scott Wichman has been a resident actor at the University of Richmond and an adjunct professor at VCU in the School of Business there. Wichman is currently in Naples, Italy, where he's serving as part of the U.S. Navy 6th Fleet COVID-19 Crisis Communications Response Team. He tells us he just wants to make a contribution he can be proud of and be an added value to the sailors who work around the clock to combat the coronavirus.